So good morning to all of you. So today we are going to start again the analysis of symmetric sections of Richter beam. In that last lecture we have seen the concept of stress analysis of beam in precious concrete member. Today we are going to see the load balancing concept and how we are going to calculate the stresses in a load balancing concept. Okay, so see here, I have taken the typical simply supported beam which having the point load at center as W and the pre-stressing force is applied as P. Okay, and here tendon is bent tendon. Okay, tendon is not straight, tendon is bent tendon. So bent tendon used here, and due to this bent tendon we are going to get the advantage, and that advantage we are going to use in this load balancing concept. Okay, so what is advantage we are going to get due to this tendon is bent? Okay, so here initially, see here, when we are going to apply the stresses, okay, so when you are going to apply the force through this tendon is provided bent as a bent. Okay, the component of this due to the inclination to this tendon, the components forces the resistance of force, okay, is going to act like this at both side due to the provision of inclination, this inclination, okay, due to this provision of inclination the tendon is having two forces now, and these forces will be P sin theta, okay, and this force is P cos theta. Same this side also, due to this, if you are going to resolve the forces, this value become again P sin theta, and this value is also P cos theta, horizontal force. Okay, and here also pre-stressing force going to act like this. So this value is P cos theta, the horizontal force which going to act, pre-stressing force, this is P cos theta, and this value also here P cos theta, like this. Okay, so if I am going to see now the axis, okay, so this is CG, neutral axis, okay, and this is pre-stressing force with inclination with the theta at the edges, okay, due to the inclination tendon provided, these two forces, the P sin theta plus this P sin theta, these two vertical forces is going to counteract the point load which is acted on a beam, that is W. So here is W, the point load, and the resistance the going to get in the beam due to this inclination. If suppose if you are not provided the inclination to the tendon, tendon is going to give only horizontal force, but here we are getting the extra vertical component, and that extra vertical component we are getting because we have provided the inclination, and the inclination we have provided by providing the bent tendon. Okay, so by providing tendon bent we are getting extra force, that P sin theta, and that is advantageous for you, because if you are going to reduce, if you are going to give the contract force to this, okay, this net value will be reduced. Okay, and if net value is reduced, bending moment is also going to reduce, and the stresses are going to reduce. Okay, so this is the main concept, load balancing concept. This load is going to get balanced by the forces developed from the tendon by providing the tendon in a inclination. Okay, so next here, load balancing concept, the axial longitudinal force provided by a tendon. See, already I have told you, so this force P cos theta, so this force here, horizontal force going to act as a P cos theta, but we are going to consider a value P only, because the approximately, since the theta is very small, okay, so that theta value is very small, that's why we are not going to consider the cos theta. So whatever the P is there, that P we are going to consider as it is. Okay, So next, direct stress on the section. So direct stress is also P by A. Already we people know that how to calculate direct stress divided by area. So force divided by area is equal to stress. So for shear, P cos theta, again we have considered that value P. So P by A, it is approximately direct stress will be this P by A. Main important thing here, this is the important part in the load balancing concept. The new part is net bending moment. Now this beam is subjected with the two moment. First is bending moment subjected with the point load, that is P, and second the bending moment due to self weight of the beam. And self weight of beam is going to act in the form of UDL. Okay, the self weight of beam is going to act in the form of UDL. So we have to calculate the two moments. So already you people know, when there is a point load, the bending moment for point load, if beam is subjected with the point load, the bending moment, if this is W and this is L, in that case the bending moment, already you people know, when it is subjected with the point load, the maximum bending moment here E will be WL/4. Okay, if beam is subjected with only point load. So we have to calculate the moment. Okay, so we have to calculate the moment due to point load and the moment due to self weight of beam. The self weight of beam is uniform load W, small W. So here that value WL/8. Earlier we have calculated the moment. So we have to calculate the two moment. But one thing, while calculating the moment due to point load, okay, then we are using WL/4. In that case, how much W you are going to consider? So this W you are not going to take as it is, because you have to consider the counteract force 2P sin theta, and then you have to calculate the net force on the member. So here you can see the net bending moment M is equal to, so this is WL/4. So this formula which they have used here, so this formula is nothing but a WL/4. And in this, the W which you have considered, so W is here, you can see. So W is this, and minus 2P sin theta. How you got value of 2P sin theta? Because the component of the vertical, just that tendon force, vertical component, 2P sin theta, will addition of these two will be the 2P sin theta. Okay, so just now we have to put here the W minus 2P sin theta into L divided by 4. So what we have done here, we are balancing the load. Okay, so that's why this concept has a load balancing concept, by providing the tendon as a bent tendon, plus as it is self weight of beam, that is WL/8. Okay, so now after getting this, is a simple thing that we have to calculate the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. So stresses at top fiber will be P by A plus M by Z, and extreme fiber stresses at bottom, that is P A minus M by Z. That already you people know how you have got the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam, when it is beam subjected with the direct stress and a bending stress. Got it? Hope that you understood this concept. If you not understood this, okay, let me know. I will clear you once again. Through this video, I think you get clear the various concept and how you know why the what is this concept of load balancing. Okay, so next, with this now concept, we are going to try to solve one problem. Okay, when the tendon is provided with the some bend. So this is problem: a prestressed concrete beam 400 mm by 600 mm in section has a span of 6 meter. The beam is prestressed with tendon bent as shown in figure. So here tendon is provided as a bent with angle with inclination angle theta, and the distance of the member, okay, the distance of that tendon provided from the bottom to the center of the tendon, the distance they have given 160. So span the figure below, the external load on the beam, the concentrated load, they given 150. So W they have given here, so W they have given is 150 at mid span. If the effective prestressing force is 1000 kN, this is P, effective force is 1000 kN, calculate the extreme stresses for the mid span of the section. So while considering this, we have to calculate the stresses. This is this cross section of the beam 400 by 600, tendon is provided with at a distance of 460. Tendon is provided from the extreme bottom fiber of the beam. Okay, so first thing we have to calculate now, what will be the theta? if tendon is provided with this height, with this depth in the beam, so what will be the value of theta? So the, let the tendon be at theta with the horizontal. So this, the tan theta is equal to, so what will be tan theta if I am going to extend this line? If I am going to consider this tan theta, what is tan theta? Tan theta is equal to always front side divided by adjacent side. Okay, front side divided by adjacent side. So what will be the front side? If you are going to see this theta, the front side of theta will be this, if this is tendon provided. Okay, sorry, this is at the base, where the distance, which distance they are given, if suppose that distance they are given as 160 here, so the distance below the neutral axis for the beam is 300. So this is 300. Okay, total distance now 300. So 300 minus 160, so this distance will be 140. So this distance will be 140. So if I will if you want to get the front distance of the theta, so that value will be 140. So you can see here, from theta the front distance, so this distance will be 140. So 140 divided by the base, so from here this is theta angle, so this base, front side divided by adjacent side, so adjacent side is nothing but half of length of beam, so total length, beam length 6 meter, so 6 meter it is mean by 3 meter, so 3 meter we are going to put this value as in mm, that is 3000. So this thing you have written here, so tan theta is equal to 140 divided by 300. If you calculate this, then you are going to get value 7 by 150. Okay, so we have calculated the value of theta, the tan theta is equal to this. Now the inclined tendon will provide an upward force at midspan. Already I have told you that this inclined tendon will going to provide upward force to the midspan. So these two upward forces, so this is one upward force and second upward force, the value of upward force P sin theta. And this is also P sin theta, because we have considered the force applied to the tendon is P, and inclination is provided, so this is P force and the inclination P sin theta. If you are going to add these two, okay, so these two, 2P sin theta, so 2P sin theta. Now we don't have the value of sin theta, so here we have to assume one thing, the sin theta is equal to tan theta. Why? Since the theta is very small, so that's why we are going to assume here sin theta is equal to tan theta. Tan theta, we are going to make assumption, since the theta value is more very small, so there will be no maximum difference by considering this value. Okay, so after considering the value 2p sin theta, here we are going to put the values which they have given. So here 2p sin theta, so 2p sin theta, 2 force they have given, sin theta, we have put the value of sin theta as a tan theta which we have calculated. So total force here 93.99. So please remember one thing here, 2p sin theta is a net force we have calculated. So net upward force we have calculated now 93.33. So net upward force 93.33 kN. So now we have to consider the net force. So this is 93.33 and this is 150. So net, this is, so we have done the load balancing here, and next here total force 150 kN here, 150 kN, and the counteract force 93.33. So 150 minus 93.33 will be 56.67. Now this much of only force we are going to consider, and we have done our work now. Which work? By using the load balancing concept, we have created this component by providing the tendon as a bent tendon, and we have reduced the load on the beam. Okay, so reduce the intensity of force for the calculation of bending moment. So bending moment due to the net vertical force, that is W1, WL by 4 is a formula for point load. So value you are going to put here, length of beam 6 meter divided by 4, you are going to get this moment here. So dead load of beam So 0.4 area into density of the concrete, 0.4 into 0.6 into 25, that is for per meter. So other dimension we have considered only 1 meter dead direction. So total load 6 kN per meter. So bending moment due to dead load, that is due to self weight, WL square by 8, you know the formula. So 6 is the load and the length 6 square divided by 8, 27. So net bending moment due to this point load and due to this self weight, so total moment here 11.84. So next thing we are going to calculate. Now the you know the formula, final stresses of the extreme top, that is direct stress and bending stresses, both will be the positive, and the bottom stresses plus P by A minus M by Z. Okay, now we are going to calculate the required terms in this equation. So area 400 by 600, that is 2.4 into 10 raised to 5 section modulus, BD square by 6, already we have seen the formula, 2.4 into 10 raised to 7, direct stress due to the pre-stressing force. So direct stress is equal to force upon area, force 1000 area, so this value become now 4.17 newton per mm square. Extreme stresses due to the bending moment, so bending moment already people know the M by Z is plus minus value. So plus minus moment, net moment we have calculated, I put here. So net moment 111.84. So 111.84 into 10 raised to 6. This is section modulus, already we have calculated. So this value plus minus 4.66. So now we are going to calculate here final stresses. So final stresses you can see here. So final stresses, the extreme stresses at top fiber will be the, after putting the value in this equation, we have got value 8.83, and final stresses extreme bottom, final stresses in the extreme bottom fiber will be here 0.49 minus, that value is a negative. So there is a little bit tension at the bottom side. Okay, so net, if you are going to put this value in diagram, you have to draw the diagram at last, and the diagram here you can see the cross section of beam, direct stresses whole value is a positive, plus the stresses, bending stresses, so bending stresses at top, there will be the positive stress, at bottom will be the tensile stress, so that is negative. So net effect of that two will be that compressive stresses at top 8.83 and bottom minus 0.49. So that's why we have shown here that value is a negative value. Okay, so this is direct stress, bending stress and combined stresses. So this way you are going to calculate the stresses in the beam when the beam is provided with the bent tendon. Okay, so this is end of this session. Next session we are going to see when tendon is provided with the eccentricity. Here is tendon is not provided with the eccentricity at the ends. So now next we are going to see when tendon is provided at the eccentricity at end, in that case how you are going to calculate the stresses. Okay, hope that you understood this session. Thank you very much.